3, 2, 1. Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and today I'm going to show you how to build a microservice using the Python FastAPI framework. We're going to take an application using Cloud9, quickly deploy it into production, test it out, and then you'll be done. So we'll be finished in just a few minutes. Go ahead and hang on, and let's go ahead and get started. Okay, I have a repo here, Noah Gift FastAPI, and it's using the FastAPI framework. And if I take a look at this real quick, we look up FastAPI, you can see it's a very popular framework that has a lot of good things into it, including the ability to do typing as well as integrated swagger. And it's very simple. And you can see some of the key features. So let's go ahead and use this FastAPI framework. Notice that I have some documentation here on how to use a containerized version as well, but I'm gonna start off with a really simple environment. I use AWS Cloud9. The reason I like it is that it's great if I'm gonna deploy a microservice to the AWS Cloud platform. And we're actually gonna use AWS App Runner, which is an emerging nice microservice framework deployment hosting from AWS. And what's nice about App Runner is you can see I have a bunch of apps here running. So let's go ahead and get started. And let's take a look at this environment here. I've got AWS Cloud9 set up. I have a Python virtual environment. You can see it's referenced right here. And I like to have a scaffolding of my project. Let me go and look at this makefile. I like to have an install, a test, a format, and a lint. I think this is a great idea. And I also use the GitHub actions here to go through here and make sure that I test my code automatically. So this is called continuous integration. I highly recommend you do it as well. Again, you can take a look at this in the Noah Gift FastAPI repo. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run this microservice here. Let's go ahead and take a look at it first. I say from FastAPI, import FastAPI. I have a hello world route here. I say hello Duke. This is from a course I'm teaching at Duke in cloud computing. And then I have a add here where I have two numbers that are added together and we return back the total. And then this thing hosts it on external interface on port 8080. So to run it, very straightforward. I just say Python main. Once I cd into the directory, which is the microservice directory, type in Python main. There we go, it's running. What's nice now is I can just open up a new terminal over here and I can just curl whatever appears in the output. This is a great thing to know about in a terminal-based environment. We go through here and we say this, great, it's working. And then if I want to test the endpoint, I can add, let's say 2 and 2, right? And we can see this works. So now that I've got this thing running, how can we hook this up into the AWS App Runner environment? Fortunately, it's very straightforward. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say create a service, and you can do this, which I have the documentation for in the repo. I'm going to select source code repository. I'm going to go ahead and pick this repository, which again is Noah Gift FastAPI. So we'll give it a second to load. And once this thing is able to find those repositories, I can select it and then use that as the source for my deployment. Here we go. So we've got a lot of repos, but I'm going to scroll down here to FastAPI, which is right here, FastAPI. Perfect. Scroll down. There's a couple options. There's automatic, which is a great idea. This would be called continuous delivery. So I'm continuously pushing my code into production or some, you know, prototype environment that I've got set up. For now, I'm going to do manual just to make it very straightforward. We'll go ahead and say manual. Runtime, we'll pick Python 3. Very straightforward. I just say Python install -r requirements because I've already got that set up. What's nice about this is that it'll be able to just use that requirements package. Next, all I need to do is type in Python main. This is the same thing I did in my Cloud9 environment. Go ahead and say next. Call this some kind of service. We'll just call this microservice 2. We'll say 2 like this. And then I can scroll down here and say next and click create and deploy. So very straightforward process. And now it's going to go through and it's going to deploy it. Since I've already done this earlier, it takes about 5 minutes to get this running. I'm going to go back to the other microservice that I have running And notice if I just click on the default domain, it's a fully encrypted URL here, which is pretty nice. And what's nice about this as well is I can actually go through and I can type in, for example, docs. And what's nice about FastAPI is it has Swagger documentation built into it. So I can go through here and play around with my API. If I click on try it out, we can go through here and we can put in 2 plus 2 and we can execute. And notice it gives us the curl command, the request URL, the code details, all this really awesome stuff. So if I was building a data engineering or machine learning API, it would be good to go. Likewise, I can also test out the full route itself. In this case, I would type an add, you know, 2 and 2. Okay, so that's all for today. Very straightforward. Go ahead and check out NoahGift FastAPI.